Now, as just an aside from this video tutorial, I wanted to talk a little bit about an athlete that has publicly described this feeling of proprioception, and it's the three-time Formula One world champion Ayrton Senna. He was a legendary driver, very fast driver. He, in the 1988 Monaco Grand Prix, described having out-of-body experiences and driving the car as if it was like driving in a tunnel. So when you think about what he's describing there, he's actually describing that he was driving well beyond his conscious understanding. And the clip's probably available on YouTube for you to view. But he's talking, as an athlete at the top of his game, he's talking about feeling something which is beyond his conscious understanding. Now, with the knowledge that we have as scientists, we know that to some degree, what he's talking about is the feedback he's getting from all of these sensors in his body. He's processing. His brain doesn't need to think. His brain knows exactly what to do. He's relying just on the feeling that he's getting from the car, from his environment, from the car, from the vibrations, from the force that he needs to put into the steering wheel to brace himself under braking, under acceleration. So this is an example of an athlete who is very much aware of his body, and he's in such a zone that he's able to perform at a very optimum level. And what's interesting about that race in particular was that he was told to slow down by his team because he was going so fast. So that brought the brain back into it, and as soon as he had to think about slowing down, he crashed. Okay, so when he was in the zone, he was reliant upon his senses. He was reliant upon the feedback his muscles, his proprioceptors were giving back to his brain, and that was enough for him to perform at peak performance. As soon as he started to think about it, then his performance went down. And again, going back to the lecture I gave to the student earlier today, there was a student in particular who talked about kayaking. So she does kayaking. And what she described was, in kayaking, you have to do a rolling maneuver, which is very much dependent upon your skill, your experience, and your feeling of doing that maneuver. When she tries to teach that maneuver to other people, she finds it difficult to describe those steps. And that's incredible. That's because when she does that movement, she's got the motor program ingrained right into her mind, and she's also getting this proprioceptive response back from her proprioceptors, so she knows exactly what to do. But it's very hard to describe this sixth sense when you're trying to teach to other people, and she talked about making mistakes when going through the steps. And we all have a sporting skill where when we try to explain it to somebody else, we have great difficulty, but when we do it, it just happens. We don't have to think about it. It just happens. We know exactly the feedback that we get in terms of whether it was a good movement or a bad movement. If you're interested in reading more about it, there is a paper called PROSC by PROSC and Gandevia, published in 2012. It's a comprehensive paper on proprioception, and I've got a link on the bottom of the video. And I've also got a link to an interview that Ayrton Senna did, where part of that interview he was talking, or he was asked about proprioception. That's also worth a read, and it will be at the bottom of the YouTube video.